don't know who you are, please tell us a small introduction of yourself. I know it's going to be like putting the whole ocean in a bucket, but do tell us, introduce yourself.
As we were discussing, I was lucky to be one of the first Rana boys to be sent out to a boarding school. Me and my uncle, though the uncle was, he's my uncle, he was younger than me. And I really give a great credit to my grandfather, because the Ranas were still ruling that time. Because that opened my mind, that look, things is not all hierarchical, you know, there is a world beyond. Look at the school, though it was a Jesuit school, very strict and all that, but it's still compared to our living thing here. It was a breath of fresh air. Okay, that's how it all. But then I did do a stint for a year, year and a half in the government, civil service. But I found I had no interest. The simple reason I tell every interviewer, because a civil servant means you have to do what you are told. And I didn't like that. I liked it to give my own thinking and thoughts. But I entered business by chance. As I told you, my sister and brother-in-law decided to build a hotel. They had no clue, we had no clue. Nothing at all. Just because tourism was coming to Nepal, there was not a proper place, say a five-star property, so that's how it came.
That was 19.
But I was involved from the very beginning. I started, as I said, from a personnel and purchase manager.
As a job?
As a job. I used to come, I used to work, I had superiors. Then slowly I became general manager, after that director, then the chairman of the company. I had a lot. I joined the hotel by chance, but its development and growth, I did play a lot of role, like bringing IFC, bringing NIDC, bringing bank. Nepal had hotels. In fact, a man called Boris, I would consider, in my insistence, they have put his statue at the tourism building, because I said he's the father of tourism. I remember him talking with King Mahendra. Sir, he says, this country is for tourism. And the late king used to laugh. He said, why would people come from Paris or everywhere to see it? He said, because of that. He was a father of tourism. He started a hotel, but he was a more innkeeper. He had a hotel. He was more interested in food and beverage than on the rooms. So, one example. He used to keep all the cash he used to gather in a biscuit tin and took it up. He was a good friend of ours. Took it up and locked it up.
So Boris
and
was
when the time came to pay, then he would take it out and pay. Sometime I used to remember when sometime he perhaps didn't also pay for a month or two, when he didn't have the cash. And his workers used to come up and say, sir, I'm getting married. And he said, you come up to my place. And then he would open the box and without counting or anything, whatever came on two fists, he would give it. So that's why he was a hotelier, I would say. He was a father of tourism, not hoteliering. And people ask me, what do you mean by then hoteliering? I said, when you have to borrow from the bank, then you have to pay, then you have to have a system.
So that's this is when was this started, the hotel?
This hotel, 1966 it was opened. And it took, at that time, I think 4 years to build it.
Wow. And the king made the decision to open Nepal?
Yes. He made a conscious decision. That's how he encouraged his brother to build a hotel. He encouraged in many ways. The airline. And also he had the German government to make a master plan.
And You are seen as a very successful entrepreneur in this country. What else have you started beside the hotel?
Well, as I said, first we started the hotel, and the hotel, you know, grew from 110 rooms and now 300 some rooms. But then we continued like travel agency. Also related travel agency, John sales agent of airlines. But then I thought, now there my family's part ends. On the tourism side, yes. Then I felt that, look, tourism is great, but, you know, there are many other opportunities in Nepal. It was a virgin, even now it's a virgin country. I mean, tourism, so what have we done? Nothing. We are sitting in a gold mine here. Then I talked to them, and they said, look, for us this hotel is good enough, you know. So if you want to branch out, we'll help you. They helped us. You know, I tell every politician I'm a monarchist. For a simple reason, I feel I owe them a debt. Not that they participated or anything like that. I may have had differences on some of their political thinking, but that's out of the question. So after that, what did we do? As I said, then I thought let's keep the tourism one side, but let's go vertical development rather than one. So I entered with ITC and British American Tobacco, the cigarette and tobacco both. It's the biggest company here in Nepal today. And they also then, ITC itself also branched out into garments, because they were doing the same in India under the brands Wills, the cigarette brands, Wills and Players, John Players. And after the success of that company, Nepal was in the same situation 16 years ago. We are sitting in the largest hydropower in the world capacity, and yet we have 18 hours of power shortage. Very similar. And Nepal was also, you know, we did away with the panchayat system, then the democratic system came. And that first 3 years, the Congress did well. They opened up the market. Otherwise, it was just like India or anywhere. Everything state-run. And I thought there was an opportunity because the government couldn't do it. And in that, I must say, I got a great help from the Americans, the American ambassador particularly. And we are still ourselves and Kimti, Gaurav's father is also involved in that, Norwegians are involved. The two private sector hydropower came at that time. Ours was Upper Bhotikosi, which was 38 megawatt. Theirs was, the name is so bad now, theirs was 42. After that, there is nothing here. And it's a huge, and India is dying from. You have a power shortage. Bangladesh has power shortage. With Bangladesh, we can even exchange. We give them hydro and take gas. You know, so much. But the SAARC has never grown. I mean, it's very disappointing that SAARC has not grown. And I blame India for this. Because it's so predominant leader. And it's the only country which has border with all of us. Otherwise, we don't even have a common border. But our culture, our thinking, our way of life is exactly the same.
So now you have ventured into hydro?
Hydro, and we will continue that. That's going to be our, because we see a great... Well, I will tell you, and you can check up this. If we build 10,000 megawatts, say, next 10 years, you know, every government comes to us, 10,000, 20,000, without knowing what the hell they are talking about. I tell them first produce 1,000, then let's talk of 10,000. No. But China is also showing great interest. But Nepal's resource is that, and it's a great resource. Not only hydro, it's the water. You know, the water is going to be the... If there is a war, it's going to be underwater in the future.
Mm.
Nepal actually sits proven 82,000 megawatt. But actually, I was in San Francisco a year ago or so. They were having this energy conference, and our honorary consul, he told me, would you like... I had not gone for that. I had gone for a holiday. I said, yes, I'd like to learn. I mean, what... And that was energy, not only hydro. There was a Harvard professor who was sitting next to me. And when he came, I came from Nepal and all that, we talked, and I told him, yes, we have, with American collaboration, we have a hydro project in Nepal. Then he turned around and told me, he says, you know, I have never met more stupid people than you Nepalese. And I said, why do you think so? And he put it on an envelope, he calculated it very quickly. He said, if you generate 10,000 megawatt, you would become, you do not need aid from any other country. Because all your neighbor needs power. And you have it. And he said, if you succeed, then maybe you people will become wiser. He said, when you see money, then you become wiser. And in the next 20 years, if you produce 20,000, no, next 5 years you produce 20,000. He said, you will be giving aid to all the countries of SAARC. Not India, but India will also borrow from you. They go all over the world to borrow money. You have so much reserve, why would they not borrow? And the day they have to borrow with you, then their big attitude will have to be brought to the proper level. And the other thing he said, of course, I didn't believe it at that time, but it's true. He said Nepal's real potential is not 82,000. He said this was done years ago. He said your potential from his calculation, you are bigger than Brazil in power. And I said, how can that be? Look at the size of Brazil. But he said, look at the main rivers that comes through to you. Brazil has only two main rivers. Second, he said, the power generation capacity. Because yours comes from the height. Brazil's power is all running on the flat land. Which is true. Now we are trying to put a second one for a 46 megawatt. And it has great many advantages, you know. One of the cost is the diversion dam. You don't need that. The same power that comes now, the clean power that is that generates the turbine, all we have to do is, after the clean water comes out of the turbine, you put 7 to 8 7 to 8 miles, let's say, another tunnel, and take it down below. And that power would be nearly double, because of the fall and then out again. Which is true. We have tourism, that's why, you know, when we say we are poor, I don't agree. I said Nepal is blessed with resource. Some countries don't even have one resource. We have power, water, we have tourism. Look at this country. I mean, everyone falls in love. But what have we done in all these years? Kathmandu, Pokhara, some wild park resorts. Nothing at all. And today, you have the two largest outgoing market for tourism, both China and India.
And what did you do in the automobile space?
Automobile set was, you know, we got the distribution of the Tata vehicle. We have one of the best relation we have are with Tatas. Their way of doing things, our way is same. We don't believe in, you know, underhand, nothing. You do a straight business, we pay the biggest tax. You know, that's foolish, because of that, they have been a great help to us. And they have given us their whole distributorship for all vehicles, which they don't do. commercial, passenger, and now even heavy equipment. That's a big business. And you know, with that, as I said, companies, yes, like, I left it on that, but my son and his young people, they have now tried to stabilize or do that. Like in the automobile, that has given us battery, that has given us tire, that has given us solar, because out of that you come to think, we have the largest Chinese company's agency for solar street lighting. So that's really big. And more than that, I can tell you this, because the relationship is so good, the Tata's managing directors themselves had told my son, look, even in the field where we are not involved, you want to put up a hydropower or anything, they said, let us know. We can help you. And how they help us is with the banks. If they give us a very good mark, the interest can be quarter to half a percent less.
Which is a very big number.
Which is Tata's strength, I mean. It is because of them. We could never have got that. So we have that trading part. In addition, now, we nearly went into real estate, but thank God we didn't, because it was overbuilt. We have purposely not gone into finance, because I go to too many banks for a small economy like this. And I felt that if we are an industrialist, we have to borrow money. Why be a competition with a bank?
And what do you think, why are there not so many chains here?
We are in tea. We are in tea also, tea tobacco, right? So, I have always believed Nepal has three areas of competitive advantage vis-a-vis even our big neighbors. Water and power, tourism, and high-value agriculture. Because if you look at Nepal's map, it's long, but the breadth is very small. If the crow flies straight, it's only 12 miles. If we stay, because of the terrain, it's this way. And in that 12 miles, we have 5 ecosystems. Again, a great boon. I mean, you can grow anything if we apply proper technique, proper. And Nepal should go for high value agriculture, because compared to our neighbor, I mean, the regular things, when they really become a food exporting country, our farmers will be murdered. How will they compete? On high-value agriculture, we can.
Makes sense. And why do you think there are not many chains of hotels in Nepal?
Well, they did come. One or two came. You know, again, the partnership didn't go well. We had a 25-year association with the Oberoi's. This hotel and our hotel division is their gift. Really, as I told you, we said we'll build a hotel. We had even borrowed money. But when I realized that there were none of us who knew how to run a hotel. And the first 2 years, I could see the hotel could be in trouble financially. So we were looking for a chain. Both Hilton and Intercontinental were interested. But at that time, we had only 120 rooms. The cost would have taken all our profits. While we are thinking this, suddenly the Oberoi's came. And I had known the Oberoi's. They were friends also. And he said, look, we are also now going to go out of India. And they said, what better than here, Nepal? And I thought, yes, because the problems are same. And this hotel, what it is, that I give a full credit to the Oberoi.
So it was Oberoi before?
It was Oberoi, Soaltee Oberoi. And what I learned from the best. Once they took over, he realized that there were many things which had to be corrected in this hotel. Rai Bahadur Oberoi himself came and stayed 6 months here to correct this hotel. And he told me, Prabhakar, you want to learn hotelering? He said, you just follow me, wherever I go. You are a smart chap, you remember?
So you had a great teacher.
No, I had that great teacher. On the tobacco, at that time, Ajit Haksar was ITC chairman. And when he retired, before the deal was talked about, the license all came, but by then he had retired. When the actual plant came, when the production came, he was not with ITC. And again, we had no clue on tobacco. So I brought him as a director from our side. And Soaltee's growth, everyone, I mean, our young people, they all learned from him. I used to remember he used to come, there's a small room there, and he had a tiny handwriting. And he taught them how things were done. When you become bigger, what do you have to do? What are the areas one should look at? Actually, I learned. I mean, I have said this to everyone. I am not even a commerce. I never took commerce. I am actually a history graduate.
But you had the desire to learn.
I had the desire to learn. And then I learned. And I got the best chance of learning from a top Ajit Haksar. He was one of the oldest Harvard alumni from India. And what he did, some are taught in the Harvard University. Particularly, you know, diluting the share of bat. At that time, Mrs. Gandhi told him, this bat cannot hold this much share now. You tell them to dilute it. But he said, madam, you know, if you do that type of thing, then no companies will come. He told him, give me time, I'll do it. And being a cash-rich company, what he did brilliantly was, he left bat on the tobacco side, but then went in other industries. Hotels, capital intensive, because they have cash.
Mm-hmm.
18 sons and 12 daughters. So, in my youth, it was a huge family.
So you come from the Prime Minister's family? Do you come from that family?
Yes, my great-grandfather. My great-grandfather.
Was the Prime Minister?
He was the Prime Minister. But the Rana Prime Minister, you know, the Rana days.
Okay. I don't know much about Nepal background, well, so I will help.
Nepal
need
was,
your help.
You know, the Nepal for 104 years, the Ranas had a hereditary prime ministership. Right? So the king, yes, highly respected everything, but they had no power. The power was in the Rana's hand. And so the 1950 revolution, in which the king and people joined, was to remove the Rana oligarchy.
Okay, that was your...
No, that was his two nephews.
Okay.
Maharaja Mohan, much later. But after he left, my great-grandfather was the only Rana Prime Minister who voluntarily retired. Otherwise, it was your lifetime.
And then who took over?
Then the Rana system was not from father to son. It was okay. The Prime Ministership went from... brother to the eldest. And then the whole generation change came to the nephews. So the two nephews, Maharaja Padma and Maharaja Padma, between them they ruled about 5.5 years, 6 years, that's all.
So what brought Nepal into republic? Why did people
this
want
was
to change?
Much later, of course. This was only about 5 years ago. Well, there was a mass movement because of the king's taking power on his own hand, right? And the situation was such, but there is, as you will know if you stay here, but there is a huge section of people said the way it was done not correct. There should have had been a referendum because they feel there is enough support. But that's not so important now. First, we have to solve the present problem. But that is also part of a problem.
Okay.
Because the king's popularity, ex-king, rising. And I think what he did very wisely, he could have created a problem. You know, when Manaki goes, you can have a bloodshed. I mean, his own palace used to have about 2 battalions, right? But voluntarily he submitted. He said, if this is the people's wish, here is my crown, my palace, this... and I leave. But he said he will live in Nepal. Even as a common citizen, he will live in Nepal. That, I think, was, to my mind, It was very wisely done. That's why his popularity is high. One is, they said, well, he's a nationalist. I mean, after all, he didn't go. Secondly, I think if you would have gone, naturally, where would he have settled if you would have gone? Either India or China. In the present political scenario, it would have created even a greater problem.
Brilliant. As a SAARC country, Nepal, are foreigners allowed to invest here?
Yes, very much.
So you can have 100% ownership?
You can even have 100% ownership.
And banking, can anybody just go in and say hi?
Banking,
can I open a bank?
It's still, you know, they are still, they said, joint venture and that. Though Standard Chartered owns the bank. It's only registered as Standard Chartered in Nepal. But that's again a foolish question, now, particularly infrastructure. How do you build infrastructure with a local bank? We need Standard Chartered, we need others who must come, and with their muscle then only the money can come. Because our total banking system cannot even build 4, 5, 6 megawatt. And again, a good example I give to everyone. Our American partner, they were not a very big company, but a growing company called Panda. They came, actually at the beginning we only owned 20%. They used to own, the Harzawe owned 5%, they and IFC owned 10%, and the rest they used to own the company. It was not because of the Maoist problem, because we had no problem at all on the plant. That was also good because we had Americans. The Maoists were afraid of Americans. Whatever, but it was not. I think that company overexpanded. And then they decided that no, let's live. I'm only in the United States. No, we are too small. Let's not go down. And naturally, they offered us the first. Now, we didn't have that type of money. And if, even as a joint venture, if the Standard Chartered was not here, we couldn't have done it. They then took us, they didn't want to lose this opportunity of the business. They then took, they from Nepal, their subcontinent headquarters Bombay, their Asian headquarters Singapore, ultimately Britain, they gave us the money to buy them out. And what could we put? We could put the share as a collateral. We had said, looking at the cash flow, we had said, give us 5 years, but we paid back in 2 years.
Very, very nice. So
that could not have happened. If there was no Standard Chartered, we could not have done it.
Mm.
There were no muscles in our banks. We have a one bank with Pakistan Bank, the Himalaya Bank. The Habib Bank owns 22%, I think, or 26%. And they supplied the chief executive for a long time.
What's stopping people to come from and investing in Nepal?
Political uncertainty and the rules and regulation. I have always said this. The problem with, we have learned too many things from India. You want a foreign investment, the whole world wants it, China wants it, forget anyone else. You have to be attractive, you have to give more, not less. Let them come in, establish them. And I tell them, look at ITC and all. Have they gone away? Have they taken the company? Look how fast they have gone. I mean, they pay 2.4% of the total tax of revenue of a government. You know, but the worst thing at present is, not only I have even explained to them, look, today, if I invest in developed world, say US, America, not at present, you would throw. Say what margin? You worked in 6 to 7%. Unless we give developing country 20%, why the hell any company leave America and want to invest here? They must have a common sense. But that's not enough. You have to give them better facility. Again, Gujarat. Why do they go to Gujarat? Because Modi He has given 14 square miles land to the Reliance to have their refinery. You have to give, otherwise why would they? Once the money comes, isn't Gujarat richer than any other province in India? And on top of that, then the bureaucracy comes in, you see. No, no, no. If we do this, suppose they do this wrong. So let's put already an act, so that they don't do it. It's not attractive. The one which they have already devised, right? It's not attractive. I said, don't think that way. Think like Mr. Modi. First you want it. Yes, there will be problem. No, nothing is 100%. When the problem comes,
then you
renegotiate, you come to terms, you said, look, this is not good enough, and the next one you will be better off.
Mm. So where do you see
Nepal? And the other is, that's the urban side. The other side is our industries also. They enter into an agreement to use that. And when the thing begins to grow, then they make sure that they are thrown out, you know. That's a very bad thing, because that leaves a very bad taste on the investing countries.
Where do you see Nepal in 20 years?
The way we are going, about the same. 10 years, we will not be able to do much. I can tell you that. Because that Maoist insurgency, which was 8 years, that itself had put Nepal 10 years back. Now, after that, no, there has been no improvement. I mean, we are sliding back and back.
But investors are going to Sri Lanka, going to Afghanistan. Why aren't they coming here?
Because of that, you see. Because first of all, there is no political stability. At least some political stability they will require. Then the rules and regulations are such, it's not investment friendly. You ask for investors to come, but then you create rules and regulations which the investor doesn't want to come.
Mm.
And you know, and we can't copy everything of India, because India is a vast country, its economy is so large. For us, even the Indian investment has to come in. But, as I said, there are 6 company joint ventures here. They have done very well.
Why are...
The only reason I tell my ministers and all, I can go and say, bring money to Nepal, is, I can say, look, in spite of everything, these 6 joint ventures, are they not multiplying their wealth by 200% every year? So it's not bad, but that's neither here nor there, you know. I mean, that's hardly an argument. Because they are established, they have a proper management system, there are many other things why they are doing well.
Mm-hmm.
And one, our own experience with Surya Nepal, the cigarette. Being a professional company, they made use of the trouble that's happened to the competitor.
Take advantage. Thank you so much, sir. Anything else you want to add?
No, that's all. Here you are. Opportunities are plenty. Sometime our friends, more than me, even Siddhartha, they ask, why do you continue in Nepal? Could come. He said, simple. He said, in spite of everything, I get a better return here than anywhere else.
When there is trouble, there would be opportunities.
Yes.
Thank you so much, sir, for your time.
All right.